Good morning, Bear Creek, and thank you for worshiping with us today. Our opening hymn will be hymn 431, Let There Be Peace on Earth. Pastor Leo.
Thank you for our worship team, and we just love praising God on this Sunday morning. God is so good to us. We trust God more and more as we navigate through these turbulent times. It is a time that we can worship God, and it builds us up. It builds us up in our heart and our faith, and encourages us to trust God even more as our God and our protector. Welcome to Bear Creek United Methodist Church, a safe, inclusive faith community seeking and growing in Christ's love. So glad that you are joining us today. We ask that you please take the time to register your attendance online. Also, I want to say a special thanks to our Stay Connected team that continues to keep us connected. And a big congratulations to all of our seniors. We want to say congratulations to you guys, to Lauren Dorsey, Chloe Lipina, also Sarah Bond, Michael Chinchella, and also Alexis Clark. You guys, we love you around here. We want you to know that we appreciate all of your hard work, and we are praying for your future as well. We have a fantastic summer reading program for the entire family. Every Monday through to July 21st, Mrs. Emily will be reading a story for the Bear Creek reading program. And then on every Wednesday, you stay tuned, because our teachers from our preschool, they're reading a story for the entire family to enjoy. You can find these videos on the preschool Facebook website and also on the Facebook page. It's exciting to see what God is doing here at Bear Creek. Also, have you registered for Vacation Bible School? All the fun starts in July. Don't miss it. It's prayer time here at Bear Creek. I thank God for you being a praying church, and especially during this time, praying for our city and for our country, especially for our leaders. We are a praying church here at Bear Creek. Thank you to the prayer warriors, also our Stephen ministers. We love them. If you have a prayer request, just click prayer request and we'll pray for you. If you feel you need someone to walk with you one-on-one through these turbulent times, then I'm gonna ask that you let us know through the Stay Connected at BearCreekUMC.org email, or give me a call at 832-773-4901, or you can text me at that number as well. Let us pray. Lord, as we pray the prayer, the peace prayer, of Saint Francis. Lord, make me an instrument of your peace. Where there is hatred, let me sow love. Where there is injury, pardon. Where there is doubt, faith. Where there is despair, hope. Where there is darkness, light. Where there is sadness, joy. O divine master, grant that I may not so much seek to be consoled as to console, to be understood as to understand, to be loved as to love. It is in giving that we receive. It is in pardoning that we are pardoned. And it is in dying that we are born to eternal life. We pray this in your Son's name, Jesus Christ, who taught us to pray. Will you join with me? Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. Don't ever give up. Don't ever give up, no matter what's going on around you or even within you. Continue to trust God and remember the words of Julian of Norwich. All shall be well, and all shall be well, and all manner of things shall be well. God is a good God to us as we continue to trust God. As we prepare to give today, look who stopped by to say hello. Leighton. Leighton, who just turned 9 years old and continues her fight against the enemy called cancer. It was a great time. She came here on the campus to visit with me, and her grandmother came. We all miss being here at church, and she just missed church so much she wanted to come. Please continue to pray for her and for her family, for continued healing, that God will continue to show up strong and mighty in her life. Thank you for your generosity in giving. It is making all the difference. We encourage you to give electronically. Of course, if you want to mail in, you may do that as well. Call Marcia here at the office if you need some help giving electronically. Let us pray. Gracious and loving God, whether we have much or little, it is not important to you as the possibility of making what we do have available to you. Jesus fed 5,000 people with only 5 loaves and a bread and 2 fish, showing us how God's love can multiply the effects of our generosity. God's kingdom is a place of abundance. Help us to trust you. Provide for those that have lost their jobs, operating on reduced income, or looking for a change of employment or even a new job. Help us to have an abundance mentality and allow every generous act to overflow from its original bounds and become part of the unbounded grace of God at work in our city, our country, and our world. In the name of the risen Christ, we pray. Amen. Remember, the Lord loves a cheerful giver. So as you give today, smile.
Still can't see, it's up to us. much to be thankful for. Look beyond ourselves, there's so much sorrow. It's way too late to say I'll cry tomorrow. Each of us must find our truth. It's so long overdue. So for what we know can be, and every day we hope for. What we still can see, it's up to us to be the change, and even so much to be thankful for. Even with our differences, there is a place we're all connected. Each of us can find each other. So much to be thankful for.
And now for a message from Pastor Lee.
Psalm 23. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the path of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, do I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of my enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil, my cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. The word of God for the people of God, and everyone said, thanks be to God. Keep calm and keep Jesus. During this COVID-19 pandemic and the social unrest caused by the long history of racism in our country, life can be scary and weird at times. But I'm encouraging you to keep calm and keep Jesus. You know, Jesus came to make us whole in our spirit, soul, and body. Jesus desires that you grow, heal, and become whole in every aspect of your life. And it is possible. You know, God loves and accepts you. Don't be afraid of asking those that you trust to help you during this time. Psalm 23 begins by saying, "The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside still waters." The first thing God wants to do is to calm us. Calm us. Keep calm and keep Jesus. That's the name of this series. People are responding to our current situation in different ways. Some people are under-responders, and some people are over-responders. The under-responders think the danger is exaggerated. They refuse to practice any of the things that would bring them safety, like good hygiene or social distancing or wearing a mask. Some get sick, and yet they don't want to stay home. Some don't even want to advocate justice at this time. It's different people reacting differently. Notice the over-responders. They become highly anxious about the infection, and some may go to great lengths and to keep themselves safe. You see some of them hoarding supplies of food, other necessities. Why? Others become angry and destroy things. How do we keep calm and keep Jesus during this time? Today, let's explore two stressors. The first one is the damaged soul. The second one, indecision. Charisma Magazine reports the damaged soul looks differently for different people. For some people, it's a conflicted soul. That's dealing with the inability to make rational decisions, tossed to and fro, highly unstable and overly emotional. Second is the tormented soul, experiencing high levels of accusation, fear of punishment, dread over past mistakes, and lack of peace. And then there is the fearful soul, that is fearful and anxious on a regular basis, paralyzed by the abnormal levels of fear. The anxious soul. It gets nervous and easily panics. The rejected soul is easily offended and continually needing affirmation. The damaged soul also includes the weary soul. The weary soul is tired and frustrated. The offended soul, the one that holds a grudge and refuses to let go of past wrongs. And then there is the wounded soul. It endures hurt and long-term wounds. And then we have the confused soul. It's unsure of its identity and lacks clarity of purpose. And lastly, there is the lost soul, refusing to accept God's grace. The 23rd Psalm gives us good news for the person that is damaged, harmed, hurt, or even lost. We have seen consequences, and we have all reacted in similar ways with tendencies toward denial, withdrawal, or even isolation. Some of us go in the opposite direction, and we're in your face, loud and angry, aggressive. Imagine the damaged soul in the midst of what we're experiencing right now, hearing the words, "God restores my soul." The second stressor we confront today is indecision. Indecision. Decisiveness is when you prefer doing or acting over thinking about the situation. Indecision is the inability to act. Deciding and judging whether we are making the right choice are some of the most fundamental activities we do on a daily basis. We're constantly making decisions. You have heard it heard, watch your thoughts, they become words. Watch your words, they become actions. Watch your actions, they become habits. Watch your habits, they become character. And watch your character, because it becomes your destiny. All of our thoughts start with a decision. Each decision affects our destiny. Thoughts are created by our mind as we constantly interpret the world around us. Without even realizing it, we are interpreting and giving our own meanings to everything that surrounds us, everything that's happening to us. Sometimes, and we must admit, that we make bad decisions based on wrong assumptions. We experience situations where deciding is difficult and stressful, and yet we must remember that indecision is a decision. God invites us in to this right path, to remember that even though God invites us, we must follow. Too often we allow the pleasure principle to guide our decision-making process of following instead of following Jesus, instead the Good Shepherd. The amount of pain often that we experience when going through the motions of making a decision influences the outcome of our decision. The more painful the process, well, the more the decision maker will try to avoid it. To overcome the pain or the fear, it must be confronted. The good news is, you don't have to confront it by yourself. Psalm 23, verse 3, in the Message Bible says, "True to your word, you let me catch my breath and send me in the right direction." Are you headed in the right direction today? We're going verse by verse through Psalm 23 and looking at God's answers to our stresses. What could it mean for a person with feelings of unworthiness, disapproval, invalidation, feeling unloved, being taken advantage of having feelings of hopelessness, failure, and shame to be restored? You see, to be restored means to bring back to the original condition. Look at what God is doing in us through Jesus Christ. God is bringing us into wholeness, restoring us to wholeness. Colossians 2 and 10 says, God has made you complete in Christ. Jesus is our good shepherd and is our model for emotional wholeness and decisiveness. Look at how Jesus walked through his enormous challenges and remained emotionally well. He experiences the storm, and yet Jesus is at peace, not in fear and despair like his disciples. He stayed calm even when Judas betrayed him, and when Peter denied him, even when he was crucified. And on the third day Jesus rose, Jesus was calm. There was once a man who did not believe in the resurrection of Jesus Christ. He did not believe in his own resurrection. After he died, his epitaph said, "Unbreakable tomb." Unbreakable tomb. You see, the tomb that had been built for him was built of marble. But one day, to everyone's surprise, that huge marble coffin split wide open. It so happened that an acorn, a little acorn, had fallen into the crevices of the stones during the construction. It gradually grew into an oak tree and eventually burst the tomb wide open. You see, mighty oaks grow from little acorns. The little acorn had life within it, and it grew and burst open death. Life alone can restore and conquer death. 2 Corinthians chapter 4 and verse 16 says, even though on the outside it often looks like we're falling apart, on the inside, where God is making new life, not a day goes by without his unfolding grace. Keep calm and keep Jesus. Jesus is working on the inside. Jesus is restoring our soul. Jesus keeps me alive. Jesus restores my inner person. Jesus refreshes my life. Jesus leads me in the right direction. Alan Keith of Lucas Digital says leadership is ultimately about creating a way for people to contribute to making something extraordinary happen. Jesus wants to restore our souls and lead you and me to make something extraordinary happen. Are you ready for what God wants to do with you in your life right now? You can make a difference. During this time, make it a habit of spending time with God, loving your neighbor, giving to the poor, advocating for justice, telling people about the love of Jesus Christ. What the enemy meant for bad, God has turned for good. God always gives you back more than what you have lost. Isaiah 61 and verse 7 says, because you got a double dose of trouble and more than your share of contempt, your inheritance in the land will be doubled and your joy will go on forever. No matter how much you've gone through, trust God. Trust God to restore your soul, to restore you to wholeness. In the words of Maya Angelou, still I rise, still I rise. You may shoot me with your words, you may cut me with your eyes, you may kill me with your hatefulness, but still like air, I rise. God wants to restore you. Keep calm and keep Jesus. Let's pray. God, I thank you so very much. Thank you that you restore the damaged soul. Thank you for helping us who are indecisive to trust you to make good decisions. We love you. If you don't know Jesus Christ as your Lord and your Savior, today is a day to invite Jesus Christ into your life, to make a decision. There are two parts to a decision. One, you make that decision, and then the second one, you commit to continuing the relationship. I want you to make a commitment to Jesus Christ today. Make the decision and then maintain that commitment. If you would like Jesus Christ to come into your life, just pray this prayer with me. Say, Father, thank you. Thank you for your Son, Jesus Christ. Come into my life. Be my Lord and be my Savior. In Jesus' name, amen. That's the decision that starts the relationship. If you need help in maintaining that relationship, I would love to be your pastor. Text me at 832-773-4901, and I would love to talk to you about that journey. God loves you, and God wants to continue to restore your soul. Put yourself in that place this week in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. God bless you. Look forward to seeing you next week.
Our closing hymn today will be hymn 377, It Is Well With My Soul, and we'll sing verses 1 and 4.
When peace like a river attendeth my way, when like sea billows roll, whatever my lot, thou hast taught me to say, it is well, it is well with my soul. my soul.
Thank you for worshiping with us today. And now, please enjoy this postlude by Dawn.